Hi there viewers, this is Glebro Junction and in this video I go through all the locos that I have in my fleet. I have so far around about 50 locos all in all, that includes all multiple units. So I will be showing you more or less everything that I own. There are a couple of locos that I won't be showing that are still in boxes or that are cut up or taken apart for some future building work. And I think I have a plaster tamper as well that's in a box that's only half built. So there's about three or four locos on the fleet that I will not be showing, but the rest of them I will be showing in this video. So we're starting from the smallest number and working my way right up to the largest loco with the biggest number. So first off is this Sentinel Shunter. This is a Hornby model, as most of you already know. This loco didn't come in yellow, it came in the SO red, and apart from the loco being a lovely looking loco, and I think every modern image layout has to have one of these, either sitting in an industrial building or in a side of some kind in a TMD. I think every modern layout has to have one. Now, as I say, this one started life off in the SO red livery, and I didn't like the livery itself. It looked very toy-like. Even if I was to weather it up, it just didn't look right. So on the internet, I'd found that there was a company that had three or four of them sitting in the siding that were in industrial yellow, and this is what I've tried to copy. It's more or less the same as what I see in the photos. So this one's been resprayed by myself and weathered quite heavily as well by myself, and I think it's a massive improvement to what it looked like when it first came out of the box. And there's a few little bits and pieces are still left to do on it. I want to look at doing some of the interior work on it, like adding a driver or something like that. But I mean, apart from the interior, it is completed, and I think it really looks the part now. I don't generally use this loco at all, to be honest. It's just there for just for show. It sits in the siding and it looks good. And so this is the first loco on the list. This is the Hornby Sentinel Shunter in industrial yellow. Next up, this is Backman Class 08. This is the 08173. This is the standard BR Blue version, and it comes weathered from the factory. It's okay. It's a suitable representation of the loco, but in my eyes, I think it could probably do with a bit more dirt and grime actually around the loco itself. But I mean, it's a nice looking loco, and this is one that I'm gonna have to concentrate at some point. It hasn't got a decoder in it, because I haven't used it in probably not since I bought it, in fact. So it needs a decoder put in it. It needs the all the buffer pipes and everything like that added to it, and then obviously I want to give it a bit more of a grime as well. And then this one should look quite nice sitting in the siding. I've got a thing for shunters. Although I don't use them, I never run them, I just think they look really nice sitting in the siding, especially in a TMD. And it just adds character to the layout. So I think, again, every layout has to have, or every modern layout has to have a few shunters sitting around in the sidings, in my opinion anyway. So this is one that's on the list of locos that I need to look at. Here we have another Class 08. This is the 08799. This is the Hornby representation of the Class 08 in EWS livery. In fact, this was probably my first shunter that I bought quite a few years ago now. And this one was my very first attempt at weathering. It's not bad, but it could have been better. And I do like this loco, but I think I need to do a bit more to the weathering on there, as it's not completely up to my standard or that I try to achieve. But for now, it looks okay. It did have all the buffer parts added to it, all the pipes and everything, but over the years they've just dropped off and disappeared. So I need to go back to that part of the loco and re-detail it. What I did do probably around a year ago is I added this little driver inside the cab, so he's poking his head out, and obviously this is try to represent real life, where, you know, a driver would stick his head out of the cab when he's hooking up to some wagons at some point somewhere. And I think that was a nice little touch, that, so I'm quite pleased with how this loco looks. And again, this is another one that just sits in the siding and just makes the layout look more realistic. Right, so next up is another Class 08, and this again is another Hornby Class 08. It's 08402, and I have to say this is probably one of my favourite locos I own, because I like the shunters, but I like this one probably the most purely because I think personally I've done a really good job on the weathering. Now this started life out looking exactly like the other Backman Class 08 BR Blue one that I showed you earlier, but this was the pristine version, or Hornby pristine version, so it was very very bright, very toy like. So I decided to try and tackle this one with a heavy grime and try and make it, or try to represent a shunter that was an aging shunter that was definitely, you know, around about 30 years old. And I think I've achieved that. I tried to mimic a few photos I was looking at online, and this probably took me a good few weeks, probably over a month, to get this looking the way it is. And I think it's come out really nicely, so I'm really pleased with this one. And like I say, this was probably one of my favourites in my fleet. All the buffer parts and everything fitted, so this one is a fully finished loco, so no more needs to be done to this one. Okay, so next up is the Class 20s, and this one here is, well, they're all Backman, aren't they? I think Hornby made a few, but they're, in my opinion, they were rubbish. This is obviously the Backman BR Blue 20034. This one came with the Backman Sounder standards, and I think I only own a handful of sound locomotives, and they drive me insane. I hate the sound. It's just too much, so I don't bother with sound, if I'm being honest. I have to really, really be in the mood to have sound on the locos. And this is probably one of the first locos I bought, so this is had the very early weathering put on it, and well, the weathering just looks really pants in my opinion, so this is one that I need to go back to and redo at some point. But other than that, it's still got all the detailing parts put on the buffer beams and stuff like that, so it's just one of those that I need to go back to and finish off. But this is obviously the Backman BR Blue version. Okay, so this is a Backman Class 20. It's the 20090. This is in the Ralph Raitt red stripe grey livery, and I think the Ralph Raitt and the Ralph Raitt red stripe livery has to be one of my favourites. I'm not too sure why, it just captivates me, and I really like that kind of livery, which is one of the other reasons why I like the locos back in the 80s and 90s. So obviously this is the Ralph Raitt version, and again this had one of my early weathering days, and I'm not 100% happy with the weathering I've done on it. It's acceptable, I suppose, for now, but it's definitely something I'm going to go back to and do properly again next time. This has got all buffer beam pipes and everything added to it, so there's nothing more I need to do to this one, apart from go back and try and get off what weathering I've done and redo it. Okay, so finally, I have another Backman Class 20, and this one is a BR Green, and well out of my era. I don't like the green era anyway. I've never run this, it's never been run, and it just stays in the box. But this loco is actually going to be a donor loco. I bought it some time ago because I wanted to respray a Class 20 into the London Underground white and red livery. So this is the plan for this one anyway, when I get round to it. Again, it's on the never-ending list of jobs to do. But one day I will get round to it, and hopefully this will end up being the red and white underground livery Class 20, and it should look a lot better than what it looks now. I know there's probably some of you out there screaming, no, keep it green, the green looks nice, blah blah blah. I can understand, you know, some of you really like the green era. I don't, so this one's definitely going to get resprayed for me. Okay, so moving on from the 25s, as I only have one 25, moving on to the 26s, and this first one here is a Helgen model, and this has got the old early D number on it. It's D5340, and I have been thinking about renumbering it onto something a little bit later. But I don't really want to touch the Loco, because again, this is probably one of the first ones I bought, and it's had the early day weathering put on it. And although my weathering skills back in them days weren't that great, this one hasn't come out too bad. I quite like the way it looks. It's got all the details added to it. It's even got the head code discs put on. And again, this is probably one of my favourite Locos. It's probably one of the first ones I bought, so I think I'll probably keep this as it is. The only thing that I will be changing on this is what I've been doing most of the Hilgen models recently has been adding new wheels. I've been adding a new steel wheels, because these older models had these brass copper type wheels on, and they just weren't very good for picking up the electrical current and obviously transferring that back to the motor. So all my other Locos, the wheels on all the other Hilgen Locos have been changed except for this one. This is one that hasn't been changed, but I've not had any issues with the wheels on this. But I think I will change them at some point. So this is a Hilgen Class 26 BR Blue. So next up is another Hilgen Class 26. This is the 26037. And again, in another one of my favourite liveries is the Rail Freight livery with four yellow ends. And I just love this livery. I just find it very striking. And it's a shame that this livery is not around anymore. Because I just think it looks fantastic on the Locos. This one has had all the wheels changed on it. Again, it's had the early day weathering put on, and it looks rubbish. So this is another one that's going to be tackled at some point when I get around to doing all of them. I'll do them together. I will clean this one down and redo it and make it look more prototypical. This has got all the buffer beam parts added onto it. Like most Hilgen models, they come with the buffer beams added on, which I think is a really good touch. Saves you messing around and messing things up. So this is a class, obviously the Hilgen Class 26 in Rail Freight. Again, one of my favourites, but I don't use it very often because I think I ruined it with the weathering. Okay, so moving on from the 26s, I wish I had a 27 to show you, but I don't. And I do want to have a 27 at some point in the BR Blue. That's definitely on my shopping list. But next up is the Class 31s. And this one is the Hornby Class 31. I think it's only Hornby that make them anyway. Unsure what the livery is, but I do like this livery. I can't remember what it's called, so if anyone knows what it is, please leave a comment so I can remind me and everyone else. This one's obviously been weathered by me as well, and I'm happy with the weathering on this. I did do the weathering when I got it years ago and wasn't happy with it, so I redid it not too long ago, and I think I've made a big improvement on how it looks. This has still got some more buffer beam parts to be added onto it, but other than that, this is the finished article and has to be probably one of my favourite ones up there. It's definitely in my top five Locos that I own, and very happy with it. The only downside to these 31s, and I've got two 31s and I've got the same problem with both, is the fans on top, the roof fans, they squeal, and it's frustrating. So I need to take them apart and disconnect the fans, because I don't really need it going around. It just makes a right horrible squealing sound, and it just goes right through me. So for that reason, this doesn't get used that often. In fact, neither of the 31s get used ever because of the sound. So that's another job that I need to get around to doing. So yeah, this is the Hornby Class 31. So next up is another Hornby Class 31, and this one is in the Network Rail yellow livery. I like the Network Rail yellow livery. I have a few Locos in this livery, and it's probably the only modern day livery that I really enjoy running. And it looks really good on the Class 31. I love the look of the Class 31s, but in this livery, it just looks really, really good. I like what Hornby have done with the Loco, added all the extra parts on it, like the lights on the front cabs. I've given it a light coat of weathering. I've not overdone it. I know these 31s were normally kept quite clean by Network Rail. So this has got all the added detail on it. It's finished. There's nothing else that needs to be done to it. So this is the Hornby Class 31 in Network Rail. Okay, so moving on to the Class 33s. First up, we have Helgen Class 33 in Network Southeast livery, 33035. This has to be my favourite loco so far. I love the 33s anyway, but I also like the Network Southeast livery, and it to be on the 33, I just love it. I think it's definitely my most favourite loco. I think I may have overdone it with the weathering. But I tried to copy a photo that I had of one that was sitting in the side, and I think it was there just for scrap, and it was really grimy. And so I tried to copy that in a way. But I think it's okay. I'm happy with it. I mean, there's nothing else that needs to be done to it anyway. All the detail has been added. I've also added new wheels to this, but I still am having problems with the run of the loco. But I think that may well be down to just having an older Hornby decoder that's in there. I know the motors in these locos draw a lot of current, and I know the Hornby decoders are not really man enough for the job, so this is probably my next loco to receive a new decoder, and hopefully this one should run like a dream. So this is the Helgen Class 33 Network Southeast livery. Okay, so next up is another Helgen Class 33. This is the 33012. This is the BR Blue version with the full yellow ends, and I really like this loco. I like the 33s, like I mentioned in the last one. This one, including the Network Southeast one, are very hard to get hold of. And I think I was very lucky to get hold of both of these. This one has obviously had a light dusting of grime put on, and I think it's an acceptable level. I really like the way it looks. It's not overdone, and it looks just right. It looks like the loco's been used. So this one is, as it stands, completed. I don't need to do nothing more to it. The buffer beam parts and everything have been added. I've also replaced the wheels and the decoder, because I had issues with this running, because I had the old brass wheels and the old rubbish Hornby decoder, and it now runs like a dream. It's perfect. It's like brand new again. So I'm really happy with this one. So hopefully in the Southeast one, once I put the decoder in, will run as good as this one. So yes, this is the Helgen Class 33 BR Blue. Okay, so next up is another Helgen Class 33, and this is the new retooled latest offering from Helgen, and there's a lot more details have been added onto this compared to the other two I've got. I'm not going to go into the little details because this video is going to run into the hours, I think, by the end of this, but this is the latest offering, so it has been upgraded quite a lot. It's got a decoder and everything in it. It runs really well. Again, it's got the steel wheels on it as standard now, rather than the brass ones, but they need to be painted up. The whole loco needs to be weathered anyway. And I've got a picture of the one I want to weather it up looking like, and I want to change the D number over to a later 33 running number. But that's something I need to look into. So this is one of a few locos that I still have to weather up. But again, once this is weathered up, I think this is going to look really, really nice. And I'm really happy with how this one looks compared to the other two. It does look a lot better in terms of detail, but I say once the weathering's done, it's going to look really nice running around the layout. So this one I bought a couple of months ago. I've got another one I'm eyeing up at the moment as well, but I think I'm gonna have to leave that one till after Christmas. So this is the third and final Helgen Class 33 in BR Blue. So next up, we move over to the larger locos. We move into the Class 37s, and this is a Backman Class 37, 37038 in BR Blue with split head code boxes. And I like the 37s with the split head code boxes. I think they look really, really unique. This is an older version of the Class 37 from Backman. This only has 8-wheel pickup and an 8-pin decoder. And because of that, I have issues with this loco running, so I need to change the decoder over into something that's a little better than what's in there. I think there's a Hornby one in there, and it's just not that great, and I need to change it from 8 to 12 wheel pickup, so the running is a lot smoother. So this is a standard chassis, so it's got no lighting in it, so that's something else I want to add to it as well. So the heavy grime added to it, I wanted it to look really old and well worn. And that's what I've done. I've given the bodywork a fading look with lots of whites and greys, because it's what they generally did back in the 80s and 90s, these locos, they faded from the sun, and then obviously giving it really heavy grime to make it look as though this loco was a good 30 years old. And for that reason, this has to be up there again with my most favourite loco. So this is the Batman Class 37 MBR Blue. Okay, so moving on to another Batman Class 37, and this is the 97301 in Network Rail Yellow again. This one's a respray, not done by me. I bought this off a friend on Ironweb called Neil, and I believe that he may have resprayed this one himself. I think he did. And it's done a good job. I really like it. And I've weathered it myself after, just to give it a little bit of grime. And it's got all the details and everything added onto it. It's got all the interior lights. In fact, actually, the body I've changed over onto another chassis, because the one that came with it was an 8-pin decoder, and I think that was only 8-wheel pickup. So I've changed it onto another chassis off another 37. So it's got 12-wheel pickup, and it's also got interior lighting and stuff like that. So this one is completed, and I have nothing more to do to this one. So yeah. I think I've got a couple of Network Rail 37s, one partially finished, and obviously this one. So this is the Batman Class 37 in Network Rail Yellow. Okay, so this is the other Class 37 Network Rail that I have. Now this is a Vitrains or V-Trains, however you say it. This was a local that had a different livery, and this is a respray that I've done myself. Now this is only partly finished. I still have the decals and buffer beam parts to add to it. In fact, I weathered this some time ago, but I just never got round to finishing it off, and I really need to finish it off. I've got new windows to put in, because what I did stupidly was varnish the loco without masking up or removing the windows, so they've gone frosted up. So I have got new ones to put in, but it's just a job that I need to get around to doing, but it's at the bottom of the list because it's not an urgent one. There's a lot of other work on that that needs to be done first. But yeah, this is the Vitrains. I think it's the only Vitrains or V-Trains loco that I own, purely because I feel they're not value for money. I think they're very cheaply built. I mean, you can pick them up quite cheap now secondhand, and you can do quite a lot to them to make them look acceptable, but as a ready-to-run unit, you know, when you buy them new and you're paying out £70, £80 for them, they're just not up to scratch. Not when you compare them to the likes of Batman. The Vitrains are just, to me, aren't good enough. So this is probably the only one that I own, and probably the only one I'll ever own. So yeah, this is the Vitrains Class 37 in partially finished Network Rail Yellow. Okay, so next up is another Batman Class 37. This is the BR Blue with the full yellow ends. This is the BR Large logo, number 37427. This come out the factory with the light weathering as standard, so I've not touched it when it comes to the weathering. Although what I have done recently is the nose ends on this 37, I've replaced the split head codes. It had the flush front ones on originally. I like this livery with the split head codes, but I think it was a slightly different variation to what I have here, because I've been told recently that this running number never had split head codes. So, okay, it's not prototypical, but I like the way it looks. So what I may do eventually is change the number over, and then I believe once I've changed the number over that the side grills below the bonnet are wrong, so they need to be changed as well. I'm not sure if that's something I'm going to want to tackle. I'm not sure where to start with that without having to ruin the loco. So if I do get around to it, I think the only thing I'm going to do to it is change the running number. But other than that, I think the split head codes on 37s look fantastic, and me putting 37 the split head codes on this 37 have made the loco look a lot better in my opinion, even though it's not prototypical. But like I was saying earlier, I don't know nothing about the trains in real life, you know, where they run, what they hauled, what they were used for, you know, what had what grills. That's just going into unknown territory for me, and it doesn't really bother me. I'll leave that to the anoraks of this world, shall I say, even though I'm not an anorak. I like the way this one looks. So this is the Batman Class 37 and BR Blue Large logo. Okay, so next up is again, another Backman Class 37, 37506, and this is in one of my favourite liveries again. This is the Ralph Raitt red stripe livery with the full yellow ends. This one was obviously come out the box pristine, and I weathered this one up myself. The picture I saw had this one was very, very heavily weathered. It was very old. So I tried to replicate that onto this one, and it's come out quite nicely. It's how I like them. I like them well worn, well weathered, and I'm happy with this one. It's got all the details added onto it, so I don't need to have to do anything more to this now. So this is one of the finished articles. It may not be up to other people's taste the way the weathering's done, but that's just the way I like it. So I think this is one of my last 37s I have, apart from a couple of others that I've got in parts. So moving on to the next model. So this is the Batman Class 37 in Ralph Raitt Red. Okay, so next up is the Class 47s, and this is the Batman Class 47, 47365. It's in the Ralph Raitt distribution, and it's the Diamond Jubilee version. I think this is one of their latest 47s that Batman released. And I have a big thing about 47s. I never used to like the 47s, but they've really grown on me over the last couple of years, and I now have this unhealthy obsession with 47s. Don't know why, but I really like them. I think it's because they were very common back in the 80s and 90s, and I really like the way they look with the liveries that they wore back in them days. So I know a lot of other people share the same passion for the 47s as what I do. If not, theirs is probably more severe. But I have quite a fair few of 47s, and I'm learning quite a lot about them as time goes on. And so this one has been weathered by myself, and it's not been heavily weathered, but it's at an acceptable standard, and I like the way it looks. And this is one of my favourites that I own, and I'm very happy with this one. I think I've still got a few more pipes to add to the buffer beam, but other than that, this one is more or less the finished article. So this is the Batman Class 47 in Ralph Raitt distribution livery. Okay, so next up is another Batman Class 47, and this one is the Intercity Titan livery. And this is, I think, right up there with the Class 08 at the beginning. This is probably one of my favourite, very, very favourites, definitely in the top five. I love this Intercity livery anyway, and being on a 47, when I like the 47s, it's a good combination. And this one has received a very heavy weathering, and I like the way it looks, very grimy, which is what they normally look like anyway. And so this one is finished. I don't have anything more to do to this one, so all the details and everything been added. So this is the finished article as well. So this is the Batman Class 47 in Intercity livery. Okay, so next up we have another Batman Class 47. This is the 47745, and this is in the I'm not sure what livery this is. It's postal delivery livery, whatever, RFD I think it is, something like that. I love this livery, really, really like this livery. I like the red livery. It's different compared to all the other liveries, which were more or less, you know, greys and blacks, you know, darker one. This one always stood out to me, and being on the 47 looks fantastic. I think it even looks nice on the 86s as well, this livery. I don't think there was many locos out there that actually wore this livery, but it looks striking on the 47, and I love it. I've got full rake of coaches as well that still need to be weathered. And this one is the let's have a look if I can get it in focus. I don't think it's going to focus, but it's the Royal London Society for the Blind. So this is the latest RFD version. I think they did the Sir Roland Hill, I think it is, correct me if I'm wrong, before this, and that's another one that I want to get. And again, they're not easy to come by, so they go for quite a bit of money on eBay, but that's definitely something I'm looking out for to add to the list. But this one's been heavily weathered by me again, and I like it. I like the way it looks. It's got all the buffer details added to it. I've also painted the jumper cables on the front of the cab. They were orange. I've got a few of them with the orange cables on, and someone pointed out to me the other day that they should be painted into black. So I did that and it looks a lot better. I didn't realise they were in black. I don't understand why they were made in orange to begin with, but it does look a lot better. They stand out a lot more. So other than that, everything else with the Loco is hunky-dory. I don't need to do nothing more. I'm happy with the way it looks and the weathering and the level of detail. So this one is another completed Loco. So this is the Batman Class 47 in postal delivery livery, or whatever it's supposed to be. Okay, so next up is another Batman Class 47. This is the 47715, and this is in a Network Southeast livery. I think this is the latest one they brought out. I love this Loco. Love this livery. Love this Loco as well. So with the two together, it's fantastic. I know a lot of other people out there really like the look of this Loco. This has only had a light weathering, mostly around the bogey and a little bit on the roof. Other than that, it's not had too much done to it. I didn't want to ruin the look of it. It's got full buffer beam detail, and also the jumper cables have been painted on this. So again, this is one of my favourites. Although I don't run it very often, I have got full rake of coaches, but it's something I don't run very often. But I need to start running it, I think, because it is a really lovely looking Loco. So this is the Batman Class 47 Network Southeast. This is the Haymarket version. So yeah, Batman Class 47 Network Southeast livery. Next up we have another Batman Class 47. This is 47573. This is the London Standard Limited Edition. I believe it's a limited edition for Model Zone. And again, this is another Loco that's quite hard to come by. Although this is not my favourite, I do like the 47s, but this is not my favourite. But saying that, even though it's not my favourite, it has to be my most cherished Loco, simply because this was the Loco that I had delivered, I think it was a couple of days before my daughter passed away. And I wanted to rename this after my daughter, Angel Olivia, and which is something I still need to get round to doing. I haven't actually got my act together and found a company that will make a plaque with her name on, so I can change it from the London Standard to Angel Olivia. This Loco has received a light coat of weathering. It's got all the buffer beam pipes added onto it. So I mean, other than the plaque that needs to be changed, this Loco is complete, and it looks really nice. I like it with the white wheels, the white ring around the wheels. I think it gives it a nice added effect. But so I didn't want to ruin it too much with the weathering, because I want it to look as pristine as possible, being it's a limited edition. So this is the Batman Class 47 in Network Southeast livery. Okay, so moving on to the Hornby Class 50. And I only own one of these. This is the BR Blue with a large logo, four yellow ends. This is probably, I think, the first Loco I ever bought, or second Loco I ever bought. So I've had this quite a while, and this is this had the first attempt at weathering on it, and it looks awful. I hate the weathering on it. I think I've ruined it. I've overdone it. So this is another one that's going to have to be stripped down and re-weathered. I'm not too bothered about doing it straight away, because I know a lot of you are going to scream at me right now, but the 50s were never really my favourite Locos. It's just, I don't see the fascination about the 50s, whereas a lot of people love them. Maybe, you know, that's just down to them, but to me, I've just never really liked the look of the 50s, hence why I only own one. This is the Centurion Class 50011, and I will get round to, you know, re-weathering it at some point, but it's definitely not at the top of my list. So this is the Batman Class 50 MBR Blue. Okay, so next up are the Class 57s, and this is the Batman Class 57, 57315 in the Reaver livery. This again was one of my first Locos, and I've ruined it with the weathering. The weathering needs to be redone on this one. This Loco is very hard to come by, and I know it goes for a lot of money, so it's definitely something that I need to really look at getting done soon, because obviously to retain its value, I need to clean it down and re-weather it. But I mean, other than the re-weathering, is the Loco sweet. In fact, it's probably my best running Loco I own. I love the look of the 57s, partly because of the fact that they are the 47 in disguise, and I love the 47s. But the 57s, I think what makes the 57 for me is the cab front with the jumper cable unit and the lights. it's just like a revised 47, and I think they've made it look even better. I think this is one of three 57s I own. So this is the Batman Class 57 in the Reaver livery. Okay, so moving on to another Batman Class 57. This is 57306, and this is in the Virgin livery. And this is the Jeff Tracy 57. And I love this 57. I really like the livery. I really like the 57s anyway. I like the way they look, but the livery makes it for me. This is a special edition one, so this is, again, very hard to get hold of. In fact, if you can get hold of one now, it's probably going to cost you a lot of money. This one's been weathered myself, and I've not overdone the weathering on it. I think it just looks just right. But again, this is probably one of my favourites. In fact, this actual loco, or the body shell that was on, it's got a different chassis on it now. I've swapped it over for another one because this particular 57 came with the old chassis with the 8-pin and the 8-wheel pickup, and it wasn't very good. So I've swapped this one over with the Arriva one for now, and it runs a lot better now. And I had to cut the wires and everything like that for the lights because they were already joined on, so I had to re-solder to reattach them, and it now runs really sweet, runs like a dream. So I'm happy the way this one looks, and this is the completed look of this loco. So this is the Batman Class 57 in Virgin livery. Okay, so moving on to my last 57, and this is the Batman Class 57, 57312, and this is in the Network Rail yellow. And well, what's not to like about this loco? I love this loco. I love the way it looks. I love the colour. I love the Network Rail yellow anyway, but being on a 57, one of my favourite looking locos, it's just one of my favourites. I love the detail I've added onto the bogies on here, the different colours of the pipes and the yellow axle boxes. To me, this is just a fantastic looking loco, and I'm glad I bought this. I'm glad I'm running you know, stock from the 80s, 90s and modern day, because obviously I wouldn't be able to run this. Although this doesn't get run very often, it's right up there with my favourites. So so this is the Batman Class 57 in Network Rail yellow. Okay, so moving on to Hornby Class 60 in EWS livery. I like the EWS livery, but I'm not keen on the Class 60s, and I know there's a massive fan base for Class 60s, and I'm probably going to get shot for saying this, but they're not my favourite either, along with the Class 50. So this is one that doesn't get run very often. This is the 100 of Who, so this is the sound version. So this was quite expensive, but although the sound on this is quite good, quite loud. I don't use sound because it drives me insane. So this is something that doesn't get used very often. I think it doesn't get used, not partly, mostly because I'm not keen on the 60s, but I don't really have a lot of EWS rolling stock to run with it, so it's pretty much stays on the shelf and doesn't do much. It gets a run every now and again. I gave it a run the other day and give it a good service. But again, this was one of my very first locos, and this has obviously had the early days of weathering, and I think I've ruined it with the weathering, so this needs to be rubbed down and re-weathered. I mean, it's okay, but it's not to my standards of what I want it to be like. And I know a lot of others are going, oh no, that's far too much, and I agree. So and some others may like it, you know. I have seen 60s and EWS that are even dirtier than this, but I think it's just the way I weathered it. To me, it just doesn't look prototypical. It looks like I've ruined it. So that's another one on the list. So that's the Hornby Class 60 in EWS livery. Okay, so moving on to the Class 66s. This is the Batman Class 66. It's the 66152 in DB Schenker red, or sheds, as they're better known. And this one, I've weathered myself, and I think the weathering is quite good on this one. Although it is one of my earlier models that I painted up. But I love the striking red livery on this. I'm not overly keen on the 66s anyway, but being in this livery, I think it makes the 66 look a hell of a lot better, in my opinion. I love this. This is probably one of my favourite locos as well. It's definitely up there with the best. I think purely because of the livery because it's so bright. And I like the way this 66 looks. I've got a couple of other 66s. I'm not overly keen on them, but this one is it catches my eye when it goes round. So this is the Batman Classic 6 in DB Schenker livery. Okay, so moving on to another Batman Class 66. This is the 66532 in Freightliner livery. I like the Freightliner livery anyway. Again, it catches the eye. And I know I said I don't like the 66s, but I think I like the 66s when they're in the right livery. I'm not keen on the Colas Rail 66. I'm not overly keen on the livery, so to me it ruins the look of the 66. But in this case, this one, I like the look of this one, even though I don't run it very often. This one is finished. It's been weathered lightly, not heavily, but lightly for me, and it's got all the details added to it. So this one, this one's a finished article, and yeah, it doesn't look too bad. So this one's the Batman Class 66 in Freightliner livery. Okay, so moving on to another Batman Class 66. This is the 66522, and this is the special edition Shanks McEwen Freightliner 66. I do like the look of this 66. I like the dark and the light green offering that's on this, and this loco is very, very hard to come by as well. If you can get older one on eBay, they go for a lot of money. I bought this one second hand for quite a lot more than what they did go for originally, but I've been wanting one of these for a long, long time, and I know a lot of people out there have wanted one of these for a while as well. So this one is probably my most prized possession, purely for the fact that this one is probably one of the hardest ones to get hold of. This one mostly stays in the box. I haven't weathered it. I haven't weathered it because I don't want to ruin the way it looks. I suppose it is. It is. I don't want to ruin it. It's not the fact that I don't want it to depreciate in value because I've weathered it. I think it's just that I don't want to ruin the way it looks. I like the way it looks. And I know I weather the locos to make them look like models rather than toys, but in this case, I think this is an exception. I think this one looks better as it is, and therefore I don't run it that often, and it just stays in the box most of the time. So this is the Batman Class 66 in Shanks Freightliner livery. Okay, so next is the Batman Class 85. This is 85101, and I received this loco yesterday. And my God, how hard is this one to get hold of? I have searched for this high and low everywhere. You just can't get this loco. I've looked over and over and over in different places, and it is very difficult. And I managed to get hold of one brand new. Paid a lot more money for it, but well worth it. This is a limited edition Class 85. Only 504 were made, so this is number 311. And I just love this loco. It's fantastic. I love the overhead electrical locos anyway. And to date, I know the one, which was the 86. So I've now got another one to go with it. But my God, this one is so difficult to get hold of. I mean, I didn't even know it existed until I seen it in a magazine when it came out. But I've never seen one on a layout or on YouTube. I don't know anyone that owns one. And I think those that do have one, it could possibly be a respray, but I feel very lucky that I actually own this one. So I've only received it yesterday. I've just put chip into there and bed it in. I just need to get around to weathering it. So this is the limited edition Batman Class 85. So next up is another overhead electrical loco, and this is the Heldron Class 86. It's 86214 in Intercity livery, and I have to say this is probably, again, right up there with the best locos that I own. I love Heldron locos anyway. I think they're probably one of the best on the market, if not the best, especially recent models. Their attention to detail is fantastic. I mean, if you look at the detailing under the around the chassis, I mean, what other models do you get that kind of detail? I don't know, or have any other models that have the same kind of detail as what Heldron put into their models. So No Hildre models can be slightly pricey, but I don't mind paying an extra bit of money when you get a well detailed model like this. But I mean, apart from the detail, the Hildre models are very heavy, so their running capabilities is fantastic compared to any other manufacturer. And they haul an awful lot of coaches or wagons. And apart from the older Hildrens that had issues with the wheels, they are fantastic runners. They're very smooth. And I like this livery on most locos anyway, but I especially liked it on the 86. I like the overhead electrical locos, and this is only the second one that I own. And I am on the market for getting a couple more 86s if we can get hold of them. I know they're not easy to come by even, and not cheap. So I'm keeping my eye out for some more. I think I want another Intercity. I know they didn't do many 86s in many liveries, Hildren. I know they did like an ex Virgin livery, which is one that I'm looking out for as well. So I think a couple more that's on the list that I'm looking at getting at some point. This one has just had a heavy weathering as well, just to make it look like it did back in the 80s and 90s. These were generally quite dirty locos. As usual, the Hildren have added all the buffer beam parts, so I have no other extra detail to add on to this. So it's had a heavy weathering on the sides and on the bogies, and also a lot of like black oily dirt added to the top of the continuaries. That's normally how they looked back in the 80s and 90s, very dirty. And I think the weather on this has come out quite well. I'm pleased with it. So this is the Hildren Class 86 in Intercity livery. Okay, so now we move on to the single DMUs, and this is the Hildren Class 128 in BR Blue Parcel Service livery. And once again, Hildren have done a fantastic job on this loco. It's brilliant. I know they've got a few variations of this out on the market, and I think I only have a couple at the moment, and I think I'll definitely get a few more. But once again, Hildren have really done a good job with the detailing on this loco. It's very, very heavy. It runs like a dream. It's fantastic. I've given it a kind of medium to heavy weathering all around, and they're generally quite dirty on the photos that I could find. There's not many photos around because these locos weren't in service for very long. I think they're only in service for a good probably 6-10 years at most. And I said there's different variations, but this is the variation I've got with the indoors. And I really like this loco. It's very nice. So this is the Hildren Class 128 in BR Blue Parcel Service. So we move on to my next Hildren Class 128, and this one is in the Royal Mail red livery. And once again, same as the last one, Hildren have done an absolutely brilliant job on this loco. It's fantastic. It's a lovely striking livery. It really does stand out really well. What they've done on this one is they've removed the gangway doors, and then obviously just put a flush front on there. All the buffer beam parts have been added onto this from factory standards, same as the last Hildren. And this one still needs to be weathered yet, so this is on the list of locos that still need to be weathered. I think I have a handful of them still left to do, but I can't wait to get the airbrush out on this one. I probably won't overdo it because I don't really want to ruin it. I do want to dim down the brightness of it a little bit, but not too much. I still want it to stand out when it's running around the layout. So this is the Hildren Class 128 in. So next up on the list is this Backman MPV Windhoff multiple purpose unit, and this is in a Network Rail livery, in the blue and green Network Rail livery, shall I say. And out of all my modern day stock, this has to be my favourite out of the modern day stuff, purely because I'm a big fan of all track maintenance unit vehicles, and I've always wanted a tamping unit, and up until now I've not been able to get hold of one. So this was the closest representation to the locos that I liked. So this is one that does get run quite often. This is it's a completed model. It's been weathered by myself. A heavy grime has been added to it, and all the extra details have been added. So a very good model. It runs very well. So this is the Batman MPV in Network Rail green and blue livery. Okay, so next up we move into the multiple units, and this is the Batman Class 150, and this is in Central Trains livery. And I own a few of these. Big fan of the Class 150s. I know a few of you out there are a big fan, the same as me. I know there's not many modern day multiple units really on offer. I mean, there's a lot of the older stuff like the 101s and 105s and 108s, but nothing that's more of a modern day. And the 150 is probably the only ones that are really worth buying. So I've got a few of these. I think they look great in all liveries. And this one is on the list to be weathered up. This is another one that I haven't got around to doing yet. So I've got quite a few. And yeah, fantastic looking loco. It runs really well, and I'm very pleased with this one. So this is the Batman Class 150 in Central Train livery. Okay, so next up is another Batman Class 150, and this is in the Arriva Trains livery. And this is my favourite Class 150, purely because of the livery. I like the way the livery has been put onto this 150. And this one has been weathered by myself. It's got like a medium level grind put on there in all the right places. And it looks just right. It looks very prototypical of how I'd see the 150s on the real railway. And for that reason, this has to be my favourite 150. So this is the Batman Class 150 in the Reaver. So once again, there's another Batman Class 150. And I'm not sure what livery this is supposed to be, but it does look good. And if anyone knows what the livery is in this, please let me know, because I've always wondered what this livery is supposed to be. This is my first 150 that I bought, and this is probably one of the first locos that I weathered as well. Even though this is one of the first ones I weathered, I think it looks okay. It looks acceptable. And the 150s, even though the size of the loco were kept quite clean, the underneath the bogies and the undercarriage were always very dirty, so I think this looks just right, in my opinion. So this is again one of my favourite 150s, even though I only own three. But I'm looking at getting some more to add to the list, because I'm not keen on most of the other DMUs that are out there. The 150s are the ones that I enjoy. So so this is my last Class 150. And unsure of what livery it is, so if anyone knows, please leave a comment. So next up is one of my larger multiple units I own. This is the Batman Class 350 Desiro in the unbranded livery. And again, Batman have done a really good job with this. It runs really, really well. It looks the part. It's got loads of lovely detail on it. And this is again on the list for the weathering. And I know this loco is going to take some time to do it properly, because there's four cars to be done. So I'm just looking for the right time, when I know I'm going to have a lot of time on my hands to make a start on this, because obviously it's going to take a few weeks to get done right. And other than the weathering, there's nothing that needs to be done to this loco. What I was thinking of doing is adding passengers inside the cabs, but I don't think I really need to, because the windows are quite dark windows. Even though they, you know, the interior does light up, it doesn't show up too much. So I don't think putting passengers in there would really make any difference. So the only thing that really needs to be done to this is the weathering. So this is the Batman Class 350 in the unbranded livery. Okay, so last on the list of locos that I own is this Hornby Pendolino in Virgin livery. And this one is just standing out of the box. It's not been weathered, it's not had anything done to it. In fact, I very rarely run this loco, because as it is only straight out of the box, it is only the four cars at present. And the Pendolino, as far as I'm aware, run nine car units. So I am still on the lookout for some more coaches for this. And I know they're not cheap if you can get your hands on them. So until I do get the extra cars that are needed, this is a loco that's just going to be stored away until that day comes, and then I will end up weathering the whole lot all in one go. But I mean, for as far as a modern image unit goes, this is a fantastic looking one. even though it is a Hornby made unit, it's only got one motor in one car and drives one bogey, so it does have issues that may need looking at. I may need to get a motor put into the other end car, maybe looking at getting more than one bogey motorised, so the unit runs a lot better. But I say that's something I'm not going to really look at and do until I've got the full nine rake car rake, and then I'll start looking into spending more money on it, because any modern day era a layout needs to have a Pendolino or a HST or something like that. HST is something again that's on my list and has been for a very long time, but again, to get full rake along with the cars, you know, you're going to need at least £300, which I think is a lot of money to pay out on the toy, really. So it's something that I need to think about in the future. So this is my last loco anyway on my fleet. So there are a couple more in boxes, and once they're finished doing, once I finish doing what I need to do to them, then obviously I'll do an update later on in time, and obviously add some more locos to the list as and when I buy them. But I think from this point on, I won't be buying many more. I'll just be looking at buying rolling stock now rather than loco. So this is it. This is my finished loco list. So I'm not sure if this video is going to be one or two parts, because I know it's going to run into quite a long time, this video. So I wanted to thank you all for watching, and please feel free to comment or subscribe. Anything that I've said is wrong, or anything that looks wrong, please comment, because I say I'm not a very prototypical person, but I am looking at ways of making my fleet look a lot better than what they are, and as prototypical as I know I can get them. But if there's any other additional comments or anything that I may have left out that anyone wants to add, then please let me know. Anyway, once again, thank you very much for watching.